In this screencast, I'm going to describe how we obtain the R-squared value and confidence limits for parameter values that we determine by nonlinear regression. We use nonlinear regression in Excel using the Excel solver in another screencast. Here, we're concentrating on how we got the values for the confidence limits and how we got the R-squared values. So we're going to go to a spreadsheet. Same spreadsheet that we used in the other screencast, and we're now going to continue to add to it to get these values. Well, here's the spreadsheet that we used to get the parameters using nonlinear regression in another spreadsheet. Now what I want to do is calculate the R-squared value first. So let me show how we do that. One of the things I'm going to do is label. So this yellow cell was the sum of the squares of the difference between the calculated value and the experimental value. And so, just so we remember that, I'm going to label this. And I'm also going to name this cell up in the upper left-hand column, SS, to make it easier to use in calculations. And the other thing we need is to calculate the sum of the squares of the difference between experimental value and the mean value, that quantity squared. And so we want to put that sum here. And so I'm just going to copy the cell here. So this then is this sum. And I'm going to put a label over here just so we make it easier to remember. And then I'm going to likewise name this cell SS mean. Well, now I'm ready to calculate R-squared value, and it's simply equal to 1 minus SS divided by SS mean. So a value close to 1, expect if it's a good fit. Let me label this also. So now let me calculate some other values that we're going to need. N is the number of data points, which in this case is 10, and P is the number of parameters, which in this case two values we got from the solver. And degrees of freedom, then, it's just a difference between these two. We're going to use that degrees of freedom subsequently. So I want to calculate the standard error. That's going to be equal to the square root of sum of the squares divided by degrees of freedom. Say we're going to use this in our calculations for confidence limits. So here I need to create a matrix that corresponds to, in the left column, first column, to derivative of R respect to V max. So that just ends up being equal S value divided by the quantity S plus Kn. So that's the derivative, and I'll just copy here. Next, it's a derivative of R respect to Kn. If we do that, again, partial derivative, it's going to equal a minus sign V max multiplied by S divided by the quantity S plus Km, and that quantity squared. And again, I want to copy the values. Now, I want to name this as the X matrix. So I'm going to highlight, go up here, and select capital X for that matrix. So the next step, and notice I'm not trying to explain the reason we're carrying out all these steps, or this would be a very long screencast. And so instead, I'm just trying to give you the mechanics how we go about getting the confidence limits. So this is taking the transpose of the X matrix and multiplying it by the inverse of the X matrix. And to do that, since it's going to end up being a 2x2 matrix, we enter the formula. And the way we're going to enter the formula is matrix inverse, and then matrix multiply to transpose. Notice these are all functions stored in Excel of X, and then multiplying those two matrices. And now the important thing is I enter not by hitting enter, but since it's matrix calculations, I do control shift enter. You can see I had left out a parenthesis, so you look up top here, you can see the inverse of multiplying the transpose of X times X and then taking the inverse is the same as what I've indicated here. Okay, so now we're almost finished. So I've indicated 5 more parameters we have to calculate. This is just the standard error that we calculated earlier, this value here squared, this SV max is equal to the square root of one element in that matrix that we obtained by multiplication multiplied by SV squared. And similarly, the SKM term is equal to the square root of SC squared term times the 2-2 element in this matrix we obtained by multiplication. And then the alpha term is 5% because we're interested in 95% confidence limits. So this is equal to inverse of value from t-distribution and alpha, which I define 5%, and degrees of freedom, which I also labeled that cell, 8. And so we need to use this number also now in our confidence interval calculations. So finally, I calculate the confidence interval. It's going to be the t value multiplied by the SV max, and likewise, the t value multiplied by SKM. And of course, we can decrease the number of significant figures here. I copied the values here with fewer significant figures than I calculated in the regression because more not really justified. And so now we've determined the confidence limits, and you can see these are values that we showed at the beginning of the screencast. So a relatively complicated procedure. Have to do quite a bit more reading to understand all this, the reasons. What I've tried to show here is just what is the procedure so we can get the confidence intervals for parameters that we've determined from nonlinear regression.